Good morning, children. In the previous class, we discussed up to the problem number 7 in exercise 10.2, up to 7 completed. Today, we will discuss from the problem 8 onwards. So, let us see the 8th problem. The inner diameter of a circular well is 3.5 meters. It is 10 meters deep. Find its inner curved surface area. Number 2, the cost of plastering this curved surface area at the rate of 40 rupees per meter square. So it is given that inner diameter of a circular well. Circular well means it is in the shape of a cylinder. So therefore, what is given that? The inner diameter. The inner diameter of a circular well. Diameter D, it is equal to 3.5 meters. So we have to know that radius only we required. So therefore, the inner radius of a circular well R equal to, that is, how can we find the radius from the diameter? Right, half of the diameter is equal to the radius, that is 3.5 by 2 meters. It is 10 meters deep, that is, the depth of a circular well of a circular well, h equal to, what is given, 10 meters. Find inner curved surface area. What do we find? Curved surface area of a well. So the well is in the shape of a cylinder. Therefore, what do we find? Curved surface area of well. Inner curved surface area of a well equal to, it is nothing but curved surface area of a cylinder. What is that? Right, 2 pi r h. That equal to, substitute in that, 2 pi 22 by 7 into r. What is r? 3.5 by 2 into h, that is 10 meters. That equal to, any cancellation is there? Right, 2 will get cancelled. 7 ones, 7, 0.5, 3.5, that is equal to 22 into 10 into 0.5, that is 5. That equal to 22 into 5, that is 110. It is the 110 meter square. It is the inner curved surface area of a well equal to 110 meter square. And the second one is asking, the cost of a plastering this curved surface area at the rate of 40 rupees per meter square. Cost of plastering per 1 meter square equal to 40 rupees. How much it is? 110 meter square is it? Then what is the cost of for 110 meter square means? What do I do? For 1 meter it is 40 rupees. For 110 meters means? Right. 40 into 110. The total cost plastering, total cost of plastering equal to 110 into 40 rupees, that equal to 11,444 rupees, that is 4,400 rupees is the total cost to plastering a well. Next, come to the problem number 9. Observe there, find the total surface area of a closed cylindrical petrol storage tank. whose diameter is 4.2 meters and height is 4.5 meters. So it is a cylindrical petrol storage tank. That is directly it is given that it is in the shape of a cylinder. What is the measurements given? The diameter of a cylindrical petrol tank. Diameter of a cylindrical petrol tank D equal to how much it is given? 4.2 meters. So therefore we require radius. Radius of a cylindrical petrol tank R equal to what is it? Half of the diameter, that is 4.2 by 2, that equal to 2.1 meters. And the height of a cylindrical petrol height of a cylindrical petrol tank H equal to how much it is given? 4.5 meters. Actually, what we have to find here? The total surface area of a cylindrical tank. That is, what is the total surface area? Total surface area of a cylindrical petrol tank equal to, what is the formula? Right, 2 pi r into h plus r. That equals to something that. We know already 2, we know pi. What is the pi value? 22 by 7 into r. What is r? 2.1 of h plus r. What is h? 4.5 plus r. 2.1. That equal to any cancellation? Right? 7 ones, 7, 0.3. 222s, 44 into 0.3. into 4.5 plus 2.1, that is right 6.6. 6.6 into 44 into 6.6 into 3. 36 18. 8. 36 18 plus 1. 19. Where is the decimal? 1.98. 44 into 1.98. Multiply that. 198 into 44. And what is the product of that 198 into 44? That equal to 87.12 meter square. 87.12 meter square. It is the total surface area of a cylindrical petrol tank. Here, observe that second bit. In that second question is asking how much steel sheet was actually used in 1 by 12th of steel was wasted in making the tank. So that 1 by 12th of steel was wasted in making the tank. 1 by 12th was wasted means it is actually used 87.12 meter square. What is given? The wasted part is wasted part of steel equal to 1 by 12. Wasted part is 1 by 12 means how much part is used to? Can you say? Right. Used part of a steel equal to 1 by 12 is wasted, that is remaining is used. That is how much? 1 part is wasted, 11 remaining 11 parts are used. That is 11 by 12. That used part of steel is nothing but 87.1. That is 11 by 12 part is equal to 87.12. Then what is the part of 1 by 12? Means 11 by 12th part is equal to 87.12, then 1 by 12th part is how much means? What is the relation between these two? Are they direct proportion or not? Yes. So, 11 by 12th part is equal to 87.12, then what is the part of 1 by 12? 1 by 12 the part equal how much? These two are in direct proportion. Therefore, what we can say, let it be x. Then how can you find? Remember from the 8th class or 7th class, direct proportion or inverse proportion. So, these two are in direct proportion. Therefore, how can you find that? X into 11 by 12 cross product equal to 87.12 into 1 by 12, that is 12 by 12. So x equal to how much it will be? X equal to 87.12 by 12. 11 by 12 becomes as the 11 by 12 is left side, take it to the right side, that is 12 by 11. 12 will get cancelled. 11 ones, 11 sevens, 77 point, what is remaining? 10. 101, that is 11 9s, 99, remaining 2, 22, 11 2s, 22, that is x equal to 7.92. It is nothing but the waste part of steel equal to 1 by 12th part is equal to 7.92. Actually, used part is 87.12. What is asked there? How much steel sheet was actually used? Therefore, what we can write that? Actually, used steel sheet equal to what we have to do? Actually used wastage plus used. That equal to how much it is? 87.12 is used and 7.92 is wasted. How much it will be? 87.12, 7.92. 87.12, 7.92. How much will be? 4, 0, 14, 15, 95. That equal to 95.04 meter square is actually used for the making the cylindrical petrol tank. Next, if you come to the, actually in some books it is given that in backside in some book answer is given there, only the curved surface area answer is given there. And next thing is total part is given, that waste part of steel is 1 by 12 it is given, but actually it is taken that used part of steel is 1 by 12, means waste part you have to find. After that addition you will get the answers. That answer is given in the backside of a book, in some books only. Next, come to the 10th problem. A one side open cylindrical drum has inner radius 28 centimeters and height 2.1 meters, how much water can store in the drum? Express in liters. Cylindrical drum has a inner radius, that is a radius of cylindrical drum R equal to, how much it is given? 28 centimeters. Height equal to, height of a cylindrical drum, H equal to, how much it is given? 2.1 meters. Observe the difference here. It is centimeters, it is in meters. Either change meters into centimeters or centimeters into meters. Then, how can we change meters into centimeters? Yes, it is 2.1 is 1 meter equal to 100 centimeters. Therefore, we should multiply with 100. That equal to 2.1 into 100. That is 210 centimeters. What we have to find? How much water you can store in the drum? Means, what you have to find for that drum? Yes, you have to find the volume of the cylinder. Therefore, volume of cylindrical drum V equal to S. What is the formula? Right. pi r square h. What is pi? You know, 22 by 7 into, what is r? 28, r square into 28 into h. What is h? 210. Any cancellation? 7 ones, 7 3 is 21, 0. That equal to what is remaining? 22 into 28 into 28 into 30. You know multiplications very well. Multiply it. Equal to 1 cm³. Actually, we don't want a centimeter cube. We have to express in the liters. That is given that 1 liter equal to 100 cm³. So, 1000 cm³. 1 liter equal to 1000 cm³. 1000 cm³ equal to 1 liter. Then, what is this? 517,440 cm³ equal to how many liters? Means what we have to do? Cm³ we have to change into liters. Yes, what we have to do? Yes, divided by 1000 liters. By 1000 liters. That is how much? 3 zeros are there. So before 3 digits there should be a decimal. That is 517.44 liters of water. That is the capacity of a cylindrical drum. Next, come to the problem number 11. What is that? The curved surface area of a cylinder is 1760 cm². Curved surface area of a cylinder. Curved surface area of cylinder. According to the formula, what is the curved surface area of the cylinder? Right. 2 pi r h equal how much it is given? 1760 cm². Its value. The volume of cylinder. Volume of cylinder. What is the formula of volume of cylinder? Right. Pi r square h. According to formula, that is formula pi r square h. And the value is given 12,320 cm³. So what we have to find? Find its height. Find its height. So let it be equation number 1. Let it be equation number 2. By making the division of these two, that is, second equation is divided by first. That is, pi r square h is divided by 2 pi r h equal to what its value? 12,320 is divided by 1760. Is there any cancellation? Right, 0, 0 will cancel. Pi h. R square is there, R, one time R is cancelled, what is remaining there? R equal to 1232 by 176 by 2 is there, it becomes as into 2. So 2 ones, 2 8 16 and one remaining one, 2 8 16. Now 11 8 88, 11 ones 11, 1, 11 ones 11. 2 to 22, 11 to 22. Excellent. 8 ones 8, 8 ones 8, remaining 3, 32, 8 fours 32. That equal to 40 centimeters. It is the radius of the cylinder. Actually, it did not ask the radius of the cylinder. What we have to find? Its height. So, substitute this R value either in first equation or in second equation. I am taking the first equation, I am substituting equation 1. Put r equal to 14 in equation 1. What is that? 2 pi r h equal to 1760 cm². That is 2 into 22 by 7 into what is R? 14 into H equal to 1760. Any cancellation? 7 ones, 7 twos. That is H equal to 1760 by 2 into 22 into 2. Any cancellation? 2 ones, 2 eights 16. And remaining 1, 2 adds 16, 0. Again 2 ones, 2 fours, 2 fours, 0. Next, 11, 11 twos 22, 11 fours 44. 2 ones 2, 2 twenties, that equal to 20, what is this, centimeters, 20 centimeters. This is the height of a cylinder, H equal to, height of a cylinder H equal to 20 centimeters. So with this, the exercise 10.2 is completed. Now come to the next topic, that is right circular cone. You know cone, I think all of you know very well cone. So when I said cone, you have to remember that it is a cone ice cream. You know all of you very well cone ice cream. How it will be the shape? It will be the shape of a cone ice cream, you know very well. This is the cone, it is the shape of a cone. So right circular cone. Observe there in your textbook, it is given there some pictures, that is top and carrot and some other, that is a cone ice cream cup, and down it is given that three figures are given, that is the in the shape of a cone, that is right circular cone. First one is, first figure is given like this. In this, it is the center of a cone, it is the radius of a cone R, it is denoted by R. It is the height of the cone, that is denoted by H, denoted by H. It is the slant height, it is denoted by L. If you observe the figure 2 and figure 3 in your textbook, the angle between these two, H and R, in first figure it is 90 degrees exactly. You can observe there. In second figure, like this, more than 90. In third figure also same, more than 90. So the second and third figures are not a right circular cones. The first one is only the right circular cone, because the angle should be the radius and height should be the right angle. Then only it is the right circular cone. So when we observe the shape of this, it is in the shape of a right circular, that is a right angle triangle. Right angle triangle means we can apply for that it is a right angle. We have to remind that Pythagoras theorem. What is the Pythagoras theorem? What is the Pythagoras theorem? It is a hypotenuse, it is a side and side. The hypotenuse square is always equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. Therefore, it is L, it is H, it is R. So, we can write the relation among these three. So, what we can write the relation from the Pythagoras theorem? That is L square equal to H square plus R square. By using this formula, we can find any of the values. If we know any of two values, we can find the other value by using this relation, by the Pythagoras theorem. So, actually how the cone is forming? Let us see. This is a circle, you know. This is the circle. If you cut the part of a circle, it becomes as the, if I am cutting this part of a circle, it becomes as the sector of a sector. It is a sector. It is the minor sector. It is the major sector. Minor sector, major sector. If we join the edges of a sector, if we join the edges of a sector without overlapping, then what we will get? In the shape of a cone, we will get. So what is happening here? The radius of a circle is becoming as the slant height of a cone. And so if we take this, I am taking the small one. So it is a cone. So how can we find the curved surface area of a cone? How can we find the curved surface area of the cone? So cone is in the shape of this. If we divide this cone into the small triangles, small parts, then it will be appeared as the number of triangles. Number of triangles means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 triangles. The area of triangles is nothing but the curved surface area of a cone. How can we find? Already we know very well what is the area of the triangle. Right, area of triangle is, you know, half into base into height. Half into base into height. So here, what is the height here? That is slant height. L is the, for this sector, it is the height. This is all these are the radius of the circle, no? Radius is R, it becomes as a slant height for the sector. That's why it is R, and if you take here, it is also R, it is also R, it is also radius, not radii. Radii is equal. Therefore, the radius becomes as the slant height. Therefore, L, that is the base is L, base into, that is height is L, so not base, height is L. Base, let it be B1, for this triangle it is B1, for this triangle it is B2, B3, so on. So, the area of a triangle is equal to half into, what is that, B1 into L plus half into B2 into L for the second triangle plus half into B3 into L plus half into B4 into L plus dash dash for the number of triangles. So easily common, half into L, B1 plus B2 plus B3 plus so on. See, once observe that, what is B1? From here to here it is B1, it is B2, it is B3, it is B4, B5, B6, so on. What is this for the cone? So this is the B1, B2, B3, B4, B5. If we change in the shape of a cone, it is nothing but the length of that, the total length is equal to the perimeter of the base of a cone. What is the perimeter? What is the shape of a what is the shape of a cone? Base of the cone, that is in the form of a circle. What is the circumference of a circle? Already we know the circumference of circle is 2 pi r. That is, the total length is equal to, we can write as L into 2 pi r. 2 will get cancelled. What is remaining? Pi r l. This is the curved surface area of a cone. This is the curved surface area of the cone. Here it is, activity is given for you, and you can do like this. You will get the same, the curved surface area of the cone equal to pi r l. By this we can conclude that curved surface area of a cone equal to pi r l. It is a cone. It is a radius r, height h, slant height l. That is the curved surface area of a cone equal to pi r l. Then next, what is the total surface area of the cone? That is, if it is only curved surface area, total surface area means how? which is adding more right base of the cone is adding. What is the shape of the base? Right circle. What is the area of the circle? Pi r square. Therefore, what we can write that total surface area of a cone equal to curved surface area, that is pi r n, plus area of the base. What is the area of the base? Pi r square. Is there any common? Pi r is common. Pi r into l plus r. This is the curved surface area of a cone. This is the curved surface area of the cone. This is the total surface area of the cone. Next, we'll come to this. Do this is given there. See the first one. Cut a right angle triangle. Stick a string along the perpendicular side as shown in the figure. Hold the both sides of a string with your hands and rotate it with constant speed. What do you observe? See, just you have to take the triangular shape of right angle triangle shape of a paper. So if it is attached with a stick, if it is rotated like this, it will be it is a string. If you rotate this, this side also will becomes like this, and all the sides it is rotating like this means it will be what happened? It will be the shape of a cone, that is right circular cone. If you rotate this, you will get the shape of a right circular cone form. Next, come to the second one. Find the curved surface area and total surface area of each of the following right circular cones. So I will do first one. The cone is given like this. I am doing first one. OPB and is given that OP equal to, that is I already know that OB is the R and OP is the H, and what is given there? OP equal to 2 cm. OP equal to 2 cm. OB equal to 3.5 cm. OB equal to 3.5 cm. That is equal. What is that? 2 cm OP is the height and 3.5 cm that is the radius r. What we have to find? Curved surface area and total surface area. Curved surface area and total surface area. Curved surface area of a cone equal to, you know the formula just now we discussed, what is that? Pi r l. But what is given there? H is given, r is given, but we don't know the l. By the Pythagoras theorem, it is the l, you know. By the Pythagoras theorem, what we can say that? L square equal to, right, h square plus r square. We know h and r, we have to find l. Substituting this, L square equal to, what is H? 2 square plus, what is R? 3.5 square. That is L square equal to, 2 square is 4, 3.5 square. How much it is? 3.5 into 3.5? Right, 12.25. Add this, 12.25 plus 4, that is 16.25. L square equal to 16.25, then L equal to, under root of 16.25. What is the square root of 16.25? You know from the first chapter, how can you find the square root? By the Dixon method, you can do that 16.25. The square root of 16.25 from the first chapter, you know how to do the division of square root. That is how, by the division method, you can do the square root of 16.25. So it is equal to approximately 4.03. That is L. L equal to 4.03. Now we have to find that curved surface area. You know already formula. What is it? Curved surface area of cone equal to pi r L. What is pi? 22/7 into r. What is r? R equal to 3.5 into L. What is L? 4.03. Any cancellation? 7 ones, 7, 0.5. That equal to 22 into 0.5. How much will be? 11. 11 into 4.03. Multiply that. 11 into 4.03. How much it will be? 44.33. It is the curved surface area of a cone, centimeter square. Next, what we want to find? Number 2, total surface area of a cone. Total surface area of cone equal to how much that is? What is the formula? 2 by r. What do we find? Total surface area of the cone. That is pi r into L plus r. That equals to something that. What is pi? 22/7 into what is r? R equal to 3.5 into L plus r. 4.03 plus again r. What is r? 3.5. That equal to any cancellation? 7 ones, 0.5. Again 23 into 0.5, that is 11 into 4.03 plus 3.5, that equal to 7.53. So multiply 11 into 7.53, how much it is? 11 into 7.53, multiply here. That equal to 82.83. That is the total surface area of given cone. Next, second problem is given there. You can try yourself and in. Next, volume of the cylinder and the next exercise. Okay, with this I'm stopping here in this class. Tomorrow we will discuss the volume of the cylinder. With this I'm stopping this class. Thank you.